What happened in Kumasi yesterday, it exposes the deficit in our governance system, that we, as politicians, must recognize that governance is continuum. You come to do what you can do best to help the country. When you leave, it is expected that the government that takes over will continue and give due credit to what was done before. It is John Mahama who procured the Ameri plant. That can never be erased from our history. And that can never be taken away from John Mahama. And the conditions under which he was able to secure that deal for Ghana, for me, it tells how visionary John Mahama is. Because at that time, John Mahama could have gone for maybe renting a power plant, and after the 5 years, they would have carried their
plant. In fact, that was one of the arguments that were made against this Ameri. That we could have opted for a rent that was too expensive.
I mean, a project that government contributed close to nothing in establishing this plant. Because this Africa, what do you call it, Middle East company, Ameri, put together their own financing. Of course, government helped in getting them an LC of 10% of the entire project. And we didn't pay anything for it. They just had to come and operate and recover their monies. And in 5 years, this plant has been given to us. This is a property of Ghana. And that is an occasion
and on the where... On the basis of that, we now have something to use to solve a problem.
Exactly. And the fact that Ameri is giving us 20%, close to 20% of our total generation capacity should tell you how visionary John Mahama was at the time in getting us this particular plant. So if you go to Kumasi and talk about how President Akufo-Addo has been faithful to Ashanti, which is a lie, barefaced lie, President Akufo-Addo has been very wicked to the people of Ashanti. Almost all the promises that he made to Ashanti has not been delivered. The interchanges that have appeared in all the 7 budgets that this government has made, none of them has materialized.
But they are in various stages of completion. They are 0% of completion.
When you put on a tracker that a project is at 0% status, that's at a level of completion.
But none of the interchanges is at zero.
Oh.
None of them is at zero.
They promised that they were going to do an interchange at Anglaga Junction.
Really?
Yes. Not even a sword has been cut for it.
Okay.
They promised an interchange at the as part of the Sofo Line project at Bekwai Runabout.
Mm-hmm.
Not groundbreaking ceremony.
But the Sofo Line interchange itself is ongoing.
Sofo Line interchange was at... I believe it was at 10 or 15% when President Akufo left office.
Uh-huh.
It is the NDC that completed the Sofo Line flyover.
Mm-hmm.
It was left with some peripheral roads, the opening of the roads leading to Ebuakwa and the opening of the roads.
So have those ones
leading
been done?
The opening of the roads leading to Ebuakwa is still under construction.
Okay.
And the last time I even passed there was no contractor on that road. Swami, they have moved many of the artisans. You can't see any significant project done there. I think it's around the
mark. So you use significant, it means that something has started.
You see, when you get to the runabout, there's nothing happening on the runabout.
Mm.
It is on your way from Makru to Bremen that you see that they are doing some digging there.
So nothing
significant has happened. You remember that the president made a statement yesterday that those, he said, I mean, insulting people who are criticizing his government, that he's praying that those who cannot see anything in his government will open their eyes wide and see. He made a similar statement when he was cutting sword for the Swami interchange. And at the Swami interchange, the energy minister sounded almost like what he did yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And we have not seen the Swami interchange. Mm-hmm. So some of these things we tend to bastardize our predecessors and what they do, their contribution. What John Mahama did in solving our energy sector problem, though, I can say that it will take a very long time to have a leader who will be so much committed and selfless to deal with a problem that has a root cause in generation. That we know that Dumso was not the making of John Mahama. We know that because of the inability of successive governments to diversify our energy generation from the hydro to thermal. President Rawlings started something. President Kufuor in 2007, when we went into an emergency situation, he also procured emergency plants. When it came, industry experts described those plants as toy generators. President Mahama, confronted with a similar situation, has produced an emergency power plant which has come to solve a permanent problem for us. And you go and stand in Kumasi and try to appropriate it when just 150 megawatts of the overall 250 megawatts that is being transported to Kumasi. What was there even for the commissioning? When Ameri was brought to Ghana, it was commissioned. It is the same power plant which has been dismembered.
But it's a different project.
A part of it. It's not a different project. It's the same power plant.
But it's a different project.
Is it? How is it a different project?
Because it's now situated in the middle belt.
I mean, how?
Unfortunately, we cannot take a part of Akosombo, or Bui, or Kpong, anywhere else.
Anywhere else. Of course. So it tells you that John Mahama was visionary. And he could think about a project that would be sustainable even in an emergency situation. He still got it right.
My view yesterday
for the people of
my
Ghana.
View yesterday was that these are routine things that are done by VRA and Greco. I did not understand the kind of unfair and presidential thing that we were trying to do. But of course, what happened yesterday then really betrays what the intent was. Because yes, anything to improve electricity distribution, whatever, VRA and Gridco and things, they do huge projects even bigger than this in many, many parts of the country. Mm. And it's routine.
Yes. So, Doc, me, I think that the energy
because
minister,
you see, to be honest, if I were in that region and the energy minister tells me that the president promised to do this.
Yes. He said it's one. The reason for the gathering,
yes,
is that the president has come to deliver a promise.
The president promised to do this. Where was that?
Yes.
And two, that this falls within the if you want to call the elite group of Akosombo and Gbon and Bui and T1, T2. Obviously, I'll feel very insulted.
But not even
because if you tell me this, what you're trying to tell me is that in terms of
the benefit that the country gets from our installed capacity, you cannot compare Bui to the Ameri plant.
Well,
Ameri has been very consistent
in terms of
giving us power. No, but what the point I'm making is that comparison would even be out of place, let alone to appropriate.
No, I guess the point he was making was that he was trying to point to
some legacy
power sources.
Yes.
By previous leaders. So Nkrumah associated with Akosombo, Achampong, Bong, Bui Kufuor.
It was obvious.
T1, T2,
Rawlings. Mahama Zero.
Then Kumasi, obviously Mahama Zero. Kumasi. T1, Akufo-Addo.
This was a vice presidential statement, though. Yeah. And I'm sure after this statement, Bawumia will not take long to name his running mate.